It's Passion Week. Jesus has made his triumphal entry on Palm Sunday. He has declared himself to be king as he entered Jerusalem, riding in on a donkey, just like David's son Solomon rode in on David's donkey, the declaration that he was the successor. The whole crowd has acknowledged, "Hosanna, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord." Jesus enters into Jerusalem and surveys the temple. It's late in the evening, and so him and his disciples head to Bethany for the evening and to spend the night. That next morning, Monday, they wake up and they make their way back to Jerusalem and back to the temple. On their way towards the temple, there is a fig tree. It's an odd detail that both Matthew and Mark include in their gospel. It simply says that Jesus was hungry, and from afar he saw a fig tree that had leaves on it, but as he approached, there was no fruit. In that moment, Jesus cursed the fig tree. Continuing on to the temple, he enters into the temple, enters into the Gentile courtyard, and begins to overturn the tables, clearing them out, chasing out the money changers and those who have turned the temple of God into a flea market. He's irate. He's angry. He is responding with an authority that causes all to grasp, "Who are you that you can do this with such authority at the temple?" Jesus' response, "My house shall be called a house of prayer." You see, Jesus' heart is broken because the Gentile courtyard, the outer courtyard, was supposed to be a place of refuge, was supposed to be a place where those who did not know God, those who were afar, could come and could taste and see, could get a sense for who God was, could enter into a time of prayer, could call out in the name of the one true God and find him near, ready, responsive, near to them. So Jesus reclaims that area. You see, from afar, the fig tree was a metaphor, an example, a symbol of the fact that from afar it looked great, but as Jesus drew near, there was no fruit. And so too was Jerusalem in the picture of the temple, this magnificent temple. It was beautiful. It looked great, but as you drew near, there was no fruit. And what was the heartbeat? What was the passion? The great conflict in Jesus's mind. It was the fact that those who were far from God did not have a place where they could come and experience God. Realize that God is near, that God does hear them. So beloved, you and I, as we draw near to our Lord and Savior this Passion Week, as we think and as we move towards Resurrection Sunday, I certainly pray that First Baptist Church, that our church, is a house of prayer, is a place where those who are far from God can draw near. I pray that this Sunday is a day that those who do not know God will enter in and will sense God's presence, will sense that God is amongst us, will sense that they can taste and see and find everlasting life. Church, would you pray with me this Monday of Passion Week for that very truth to be evident this Sunday, that all who are far off will come near and will find water that springs up to eternal life. God bless you guys. We'll see you Sunday.